Hello, everyone, and welcome back to the One-Stop Co-op Shop. This is Colin, and today we're finally going to start our solo playthrough of Wisdom of Solomon. Sorry, you guys, this took so long, but I did not realize with work and year-end, I was going to be so overwhelmed. So we are now done with year-end. It's a new year. Let's get to some games. So Jeroboam is first player, so he'll do his first action. And how we determine that is we draw a token out of this bag. We'll grab our bag, give the tokens a good shuffle, and we'll draw this one. This is the temple icon, which means that Jeroboam will want to do a temple action if he can. Now, if we look over here, it costs either one stone, one wood, and one food, or one gold and one clay to be able to go to this location. Jeroboam does not have any of the correct resources here, so we're just going to go ahead and grab another tile. So let's see. This time he's going to get the other temple. That's not going to work. Okay, let's go ahead and grab a different one. Ooh, this is what we call a holy place icon. Now, there are four different holy place locations that you can go to. The first time you draw this from Jeroboam's bag, you just set it aside. If he draws a second one, he's going to place all the rest of his workers, which right now is six, so hopefully he doesn't do that for himself. But let's say that he did that, he would then place all of his remaining workers into one of the four holy places and activate that action. But that's just the first one, so we'll just set that aside, and we'll draw another one. Come on, let's see. We got to get something that we can do. Okay, we're going to try and build a building. We have our five buildings here, and we have our three resources. We have food, we have stone, and we have clay. What Jeroboam can do is he can build a building for one less resource than what's on the card itself, and it could be the most expensive one. So we want to always start at the bottom and move up because, of course, he wants the most favor. So does he have at least one wood and one gold or maybe two wood? He doesn't have it, so he can't build the copper mine. He can't build the harbor because he doesn't have stone and wood. He has stone, but he has clay, so that won't work. He doesn't have clay and two pieces of food. He has one piece of food. But down here, the lumber camp, he can pay one here and one here to go ahead and build that. He gave up one food, so he doesn't have to pay the one food, but he can build the lumber camp and gain himself three total favor. Also, going forward, whenever he goes to a location on the map and he gains wood, he'll actually gain plus two wood because he has the lumberjack building. To do his activation, he will have to use one of his six workers, and he has to place it in one of these three locations. We cannot use these ones unless we're playing with 3 to 5 players or 4 to 5 players. He also gained 3 favor, 1, 2, 3, by building that specific building. Now what he's going to do is he gets to place one of his 6 custom houses. How we determine where that's going to go is we draw from this bag until we get a location tile. Oh, we found one right away. We have Ammon. So what we'll do is we'll place his custom home on that location. He'll place his first custom building here, and then he gets to build a road. He can build a road to any location that does not already have a road. None of them have roads yet. So what he's going to do is place a road for the highest valued resource. So that would be this stone. We've got the Dead Sea here, so we can't get to Judah. Over here, this has a scarcity icon, so that means we don't have any resources, and this is just wood. So now, if ever he places his worker in Ammon, he will also get one stone because he has roads, a road here. So that's something important to note on how this board works. If he places his worker here, he'll gain one food and one stone. Well, I'm not going to let Jeroboam have all the fun over here. I'm also going to build a building. So I'm going to come here. I'm going to build this copper mine. That cost me 1 gold and 2 wood. That's the whole reason I got it. I'm going to gain 10 victory points. And now going forward, every time I go to a location that gains me clay, I gain plus 1 additional clay. I'll move from 6 favor all the way up to 16 favor. I'm then going to place my custom home right here in Geshur, and I'm going to put a road over here to Bashan. So now if I go to Geshur, as long as there is no worker here, I can collect both food, stone, and I can collect wood. Kind of cool. We'll move back again to Jeroboam. We'll grab from the bag, and we have Gilead. So What that means is he'll place a worker in Galad and activate that location. He'll place his worker here. That simply means he gains one wood. If he had had a custom home here, he could have used any roads that were connected, but there is no custom home here and not his custom home, so nothing that he can do other than gain the one wood. For my second action, I'm going to come here to Geysir. Now, I did explain one thing incorrectly, and I want to make sure you understand this. If there is a custom house that's not yours in a location, you cannot claim the goods that are there. So I can go to Geysir and I can get these two goods. But what I'm doing now is I'm blocking Jeroboam from being able to come here to Ammon and trying to collect goods from Geysir because I have a custom house there. So I will collect both one wood and one stone from the supplies. Jeroboam will respond with, let's see, he's going to go to another location, that is Phoenicia. Now, you see how this says solo 1x? That means I am no longer going to ever put that token back into this bag. He's going to go there one time, and that's it. If you look here, Phoenicia has two wood, so I'm going to grab two wood for him, put that in his supply with his one wood and one clay. And now the reason why he will not go there again is because there's no place for him to put a custom house. So he'll go there one time in the game if you drop from the bag. For my next activation, I think I'm going to go ahead and move to the marketplace. You can buy and sell up to three goods, unless you have different abilities. After you do your buying or selling, you can play a fortune card from your hand, if you would like. And I think I'm going to. What I'm going to do is I'm going to buy all three of these goods. So this one costs 2, 1, and 1. So that's 4 total favor. I'll move myself 1, 2, 3, 4 down on the favor track, and then I will play the Liberal Soul. I can spend any 3 resources and gain 10 favor. So I'll use 1 food, 1 wood, and 1 stone, and that will allow me to move up by 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Nice. I'm at 22. Moving back to Jeroboam, we'll grab his bag. Let's see what he's going to do. He's got 3 workers left. So this means he will try and place one of his workers on one of his buildings. His building does not have a worker spot, so we'll go ahead and just move that off. And we'll grab a different one. Let's do this one. He's going to try and do the temple. Well, all he has is lots of wood and 1 clay. Can't do the temple yet. So let's see. He's got a little bit of a resource issue right now. So my guess is at some point he's going to go to the trader. But first, he's going to go to Judah. One time he'll do it per the solo game. So I'll remove this from the bag completely. Judah will go ahead and give him 1 gold. One of the 2 ways to end this game is to build all the temples that are out on the board. There's a total of 9. I'm going to go ahead and do 1 build of a temple action. So I'm going to come here. I can either spend 1 stone, 1 wood, and 1 food, or 1 gold and 1 clay, and I have gold and clay, plus 1 of any resource equal to the amount of other workers are at this location. I'm the first one, so I don't have to. I don't have to pay any additional. What we now get to do is grab 1 of these tile tokens, and we get to reveal it for ourselves, 8. So at the end of the game, we'll gain 8 favor for that. But I'm going to keep it face down because technically Jeroboam or any other player wouldn't know how much that is. I have 1 of the 9, so there's only 8 left. I also get to draw 1 fortune card, and this can go into my hand. And I have inheritance. Take a building card, do not add a customs house, road, or gain any favor. Ooh, I can just grab any building with that when I play it. And now we're back to Jeroboam. So he'll grab his bag. Let's give him a good shuffle. And he is going to do, as an action, ooh, a trading action. Jeroboam will place one of his workers here. Now, if we went to the trader, we could turn 1 good into 2 of any type of goods that we wanted. These 2 have to be the same type of goods. They cannot be exotic goods, except for for Jeroboam, they can. So what he will do is he'll take the resource that he has the most of, which is wood. He'll trade 1 wood, and he'll get 2 exotic goods. That's going to give him a lot of flexibility because he pays 1 less for resources, and these exotic goods are wild. They can be any type of resource. So yeah, he is resource happy now. The action that I'm going to take is I'm going to go ahead and come to Aram just so I can get 2 food because right now I have no resources. So now I have 2 food as resources. Jeroboam will grab from this bag. We'll give a draw. And we have, he's going to build a temple. Jeroboam certainly has enough resources to be able to do this. Now, if he can, he will pay these three resources instead of these two. And he certainly can with his wilds. He also doesn't have to do the discard of one per the amount of workers. So he will just use two of his wilds and one wood to pay for these. He grabs one of these tile tokens. I'm going to keep it face down so I don't know what it is. And he also gets to draw a fortune card. I'll keep it face down. It doesn't really matter what it does because he'll just use it for victory points. And of course, by victory points, I mean favor. There's one thing I missed when I did the traitor action for Jeroboam, and that is that he can play a fortune card. Now, unlike us, we play it for our abilities. He just will discard it. So he's going to discard that favor card, fortune card for 5 favor. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So he's now at 15 favor. We have one final action, and we took a chance, and it paid off for us. Jeroboam did not go to any of the holy places on the board. They, first of all, give you the first player token, but second of all, give you some pretty substantial abilities. Like if you come here to the Altar of Incense, you get 1 exotic good and 8 favor. Or if you come over here to the Ark of the Covenant, you gain 3 fortune cards. What we're going to do, though, because I am totally strapped on resources, I'm going to come to the Table of Presents. Now, I have to place all the remaining workers I have in that spot. And once I go there, no one else can go to any of the holy places. So when you're playing this competitively, you might want to go there with 2 or 3 workers just so that you get the benefit and your opponents don't. Here, I took a little bit of a chance. I kind of thought, you know, he's probably not going to draw that second icon that would have him go to the holy place, and he didn't, so that's nice. So I will now gain 1 of every resource type, minus, of course, the exotic goods. Finally, I also gain the first player token, so I get to go first in the next round, which is nice. At the end of the year, we check to see if the game is completed. If any players placed all of their custom houses, we're done. That has not happened. We've each only placed 1. If the last available temple tile has been acquired, then we're done. But we've only grabbed 2, so we're okay. So what we do now is we'll return all of our workers. So the next thing we should do is move the resources down in the marketplace. But as you can see, there are no resources here, so we don't have to do that. But just for an example, let's say we had wood at the 3 spot. We'd push it all the way down to the 1, so it's easier to purchase. But didn't have to worry about that. There's no resources there. Now we need to fill up the bottom 2 of each of these. We fill them from the supplies, and if ever the supplies are empty, we replace that with an exotic good. Right now, I have more than enough in storage, so we're fine. But let's say I didn't. I have to start with the most expensive gold. So let's say I only had 1 gold. Well, the second one here would actually be an exotic good. It's kind of a cool way to get the exotic goods out on the board. But right now, the way we played the last round, we have enough resources for all of them to have the bottom 2 filled up. We then will slide all of the buildings down as well. We'll move this one down. Put this one out. We've got an armory. Ooh. And then we have a building that's going to be on top. It's a captain or harbor ability. And now what we'll do is we'll move to the next year. We'll take all of the tiles that we revealed from Jeroboam's bag, put them back in there with the exception of those 2 solo 1X tokens. Those are gone from the bag completely. Let's start the next round. I'm first player this round, so the first thing I'm going to do is build a building. And I'm going to build this harbor. So I've got 1 gold, 1 stone, and 1 wood. I also gain 10 favor. I'll move from 22 all the way up to 32. We've got our bag here for Jeroboam. We'll grab a tile. He's still got some pretty good resources. Okay, he's going to go to the marketplace. First thing he'll do before I forget is he will discard his fortune card for 5 favor. He'll then place his worker here and look to buy the resources he does not have. So he has 1 gold, 1 clay, and 1 wood. So he'll start with the cheapest one, which will be this 1 food. So he'll spend 1 favor. He goes down to 19 to do that, to purchase that first one. He does not have any stone, so he'll go ahead and spend 1 for 1 stone. He'll move favor down to 18. Now he has 1 of every type of resource. So then he'll sell the resource that gives him the most favor, and that's going to be his gold. So he will place the gold here in this 5 spot and gain 5 favor, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and that's going to put him at 23 favor. And you guys, I'm totally terrible. I forgot to place my own custom house. I'm going to place that in Bashan, and I'm going to go ahead and put a road out of Bashan to Zeboah. So that way, if I go to Bashan, I can get some good resources. And because of that, I think that's exactly what I'm going to do. I'm going to go to Bashan. This is going to get me one wood plus one stone and one stone. So two stone and one wood. Thank you, Bashan. Moving back to Jeroboam, he will grab this tile, and he is going to go to Zeboah. By going to Zeboah, he will go ahead and just grab one stone, but the other thing is he cuts me off there. I'm not able to then, I mean, I've already gone to Bashan, but let's say I tried to go to Geshur. I could have technically gotten one stone, and then this is still connected by road, another stone from Zeboah. Well, now I can't because there's a worker there. For my action this round, I'm going to go ahead and do a building action. I'm going to come here and use my harbor. I'm just going to discard this inheritance. I mean, it'd be cool to have it, but look at this. I can get three of any resources. I'm going to grab the three exotic resources that we have. Heck yeah. Moving back to Jeroboam, let's go ahead and grab from here. And he is going to go to Ammon. Too bad for Jeroboam. Going to Ammon will get him one food, which is great. Now, he does not get any from Geshur because my custom house is there. But it's still connected to the road to Bashan, but I have a house there as well. Then it's connected to the Zeboah, but he has a worker there, so he can't get that resource. So it was an okay move, but actually it was pretty terrible because I had already placed those two houses there and blocked with Bashan and Geshur, and he blocked himself in Zeboah. What do you guys say we build some temples, huh? We'll start going here, grabbing one food, one wood, and one stone. I don't have to pay any additional resources because there's no other workers there. I also grab one fortune card, and I have just wait. Slide all the marker resources down. You may buy and sell three resources. That's kind of cool. And we'll grab one of the tiles, and that is a 9. Whoa, that's going to be 9 victory or favor points at the end of the game. We'll go ahead and grab for Jeroboam. He will, let's see. Ooh, okay, so that's one of the holy places. So we'll place that aside. If he grabs another one, he's going to go to one of the holy places. Let's see, he'll grab this one. And no, he's going to try and build a temple. He sees me building, he goes, wait, I got to do it too. He most certainly has enough resources, so he'll come here. He doesn't have to pay the plus one additional resource. He's got one of each. He'll grab this tile. I'm not going to look at it, so I don't know what he's at. And he grabs one fortune card. I'm not going to let him have all the fun, though. I'm going to go ahead and use an exotic good and one clay, and then spend two food for the two workers that are there. And I'm going to come here, and I'm going to get another one of these. This is a 6. Ah, bummer, it's not a 9. If that had been a 9, that'd be insane. And I get another fortune card, and mine is Directed Paths. Add one road to the board, then receive one favor per road touching your custom house locations. Cool. We'll go ahead and grab another tile for Jeroboam, and he is going to try and build a building. However, looking at all the buildings that are available, he does not have the resources to be able to do that. So let's just grab a different one. Let's do this one. Oh, he's going to try and build. He can't build. Couldn't build last time, dude. Can't build this time, okay? Then he's going to try and do an action on one of his buildings. Can't do that either because he doesn't have a building with an action. So let's grab another one. And we have he's going to trade. Oh, he's going to get some more exotic goods. Jeroboam will go ahead and place his worker here. There's actually only one exotic good. So what he's going to do is he's going to spend his cheapest resource, which is food. He's going to get two of the most expensive resource that there's two of, and that's the clay. So he'll gain 2 clay because there's actually only 1 gold out in the supply. So that also wouldn't work. He will, though, also discard his fortune card and gain 5 more favor. He's going to jump himself to 28. Yeah, so he's keeping up with me. For my final action, I'm going to go to the holy places. I'm going to go to the altar of incense. So that's going to gain me 1 exotic good and 8 favor. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I am now at 40 favor. Jeroboam will go ahead and grab from the bag, and he is going to... Oh, I got lucky. That normally would mean he'd go to the holy places because that's his second one of those. But I already went there, so he can't. Oh, that's lucky. He's going to go to the marketplace. Jeroboam's decided it's time for him to get enough resources he can do something cool with it. So he only has two resources right now, clay and stone. So he's going to grab one of the other three. So gold for two, wood for one, and food for one. So that's a total of 4 favor he spent. That'll move him down to 24 favor. Now, if he had a fortune card, he could then discard it for 5 favor. But he doesn't have any more fortune cards, so he can't do that. This will end our round. We'll go ahead and push the resources down in the marketplace, and then we replenish them. So we'll have 2 stone here, and we'll have 2 wood, and then 2 food. We've got tons of food. So if I had had any that we didn't have any left in the supply, we would have started placing exotic goods. Oh, but I actually have all the exotic goods, so that wouldn't even have happened. We've removed our workers. Let's move our buildings down. And our new one is a bazaar. Okay, you get 1 additional good, it looks like, at the marketplace. Or you can push it down and then buy it. So that'll end this year. Let's go ahead and jump in to the next year. I think I might try and rush it here before Jeroboam gets too powerful. Let's do it. Since we went to the holy places first again, we get to go first this round. Let's go ahead and build a temple. We'll use 2 exotic goods. We don't have to pay any additional resources. We'll grab one of these. Oh, 7 victory points, or favor points, not bad. And we get to draw a fortune card. This one says, this year, anytime one opponent places a worker on a customs house location, they must lose 3 favor. Yeah, it's not great, because I have no idea when Jeroboam's going to do that. Jeroboam is next. Let's grab from here. He will go ahead and go to Bashan. Now, that's just mean. He's going to go here. The only thing he can collect is wood. He'll grab 1 wood, but he totally blocks me because now there's a worker there and I can't gain resources like when I go to Geshur and get any from Bashan because he has a worker there. Ugh. For my second action, I think I am going to go to the harbor. I'm going to discard that bot wisdom and I am going to gain 3 resources. I'm going to gain 2 of the exotic and 1 of the stone. Jeroboam will counter as he's still laughing at me about Bashan. He will grab, let's do this one. Okay, that's the first of the holy places. If he grabs the second one of those, he's done and he takes the first player token. Nope, he's going to go to Ammon. Going to Ammon will give him 1 food. He can't collect anything from Geshur. He can't collect anything from Bashan, but he will get 1 stone. So 1 stone and 1 food. I'm trying to finish this game here. He's ticking me off. So I'm going to go ahead and use 2 exotic goods for the gold and clay, and then 1 additional resource because I have a worker here. That's going to get me another temple, and that's 9 more victory points. Yeah, see, I think I'm going to kill him this way. This is helping me. And we have a fortune card. Collect 2 resources of each resource type blocked by shortage tiles. Ooh, that's kind of cool. We'll go ahead and move to Jeroboam. He will do a marketplace action. He now has 1 of every resource. So he's going to come over here. He is going to start selling his duplicates. So he has the most clay. So he'll go ahead and spend that. He'll gain 4 favor for that. Then he'll go ahead and move to the wood. That will give him 3, so that's 7. And then he'll do stone. That's another 4. So 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. That's 11 favor, you guys. Woo! That puts him just 5 favor behind me. He's at 35, I'm at 40. For my fourth action, I'm also going to come over here to the marketplace. I'm going to buy 1 stone. Actually, I already have stone. I'm good on stone. So 1 wood for 1 and 1 food for 1. And then let's do 1 gold for 2. So that's a total of 4 favor that I go back. So now I'm only going to be 1 favor ahead of Jeroboam. We'll push ourselves back all the way to here. But I still think I'm doing okay thanks to all of those temple tokens that I have. We'll move back to Jeroboam. We'll go ahead and grab from this bag. And let's see what he's going to do. Oh, he sees me building temple tiles and he goes, you know what? I got to get myself some. He'll go ahead and place 1 worker here like so. Here's his 3 resources that he's paying. He will get this temple token tile and he will get a fortune card face down. And because of that, I think I'm going to go ahead and finish the game here. I'm going to come here, do this same thing. I have one gold and one wild, so that's going to be my clay. I need to spend three other resources because there's three other workers here. Here are my three resources. This is my last temple tile, and I have six favor because of that. That's nice. But that's going to end the game. I shouldn't say it should end the game because we each still can do our actions for the rest of the round. But at the end of this year, we're done. We'll move back to Jeroboam. We'll go ahead and grab from in here. And we have, he knows it's the end of the round now. He is going to go ahead and go to a holy place. He has placed or grabbed two holy place tokens. That means he'll place his remaining two workers onto one of the holy place locations. Oh, I did not actually see that coming. Since his second holy place icon was the altar of incense, he's going to go there and gain himself eight favor, you guys. He'll pop himself here, and he'll go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So he just jumped ahead of me, 43 to 36. And honestly, I have one worker left, but I have no resources. I went all the way down to zero to get what I had, and there's nothing I can do. I can gain resources, but resources are useless for points. So we'll go ahead and just end the round, and we'll end the game. Let's count up to see who won. Let's first add up for Jeroboam. So the first thing is he had one fortune card in his hand. That's two more favor. So two here. Now, I was just telling you that for us, we don't get any benefits for leftover resources, but Jeroboam does. He gets one favor for every two resources. So that is a total of three favor for these items here. Then we'll add 8 to that, so that's 11 plus 6 is 17 plus 8 is 25. So he added 25 favor to his final score. Jeroboam ended with 50 plus 18, so 68 favor. Currently, I'm only at 36 favor, but I might have been able to catch up with him. Let's see. I get 2 favor for each of these cards. That's 2, 4, 6. 6 plus 9 is 15. Plus 6 is 21. Plus 9 is 30. Plus these two is 45. Plus this is 51. 51 plus 36. That puts me at a total of 87 favor. So that means I actually did beat Jeroboam. I'm telling you, those temple tokens can be very, very beneficial. So even though Jeroboam stole the holy place from me right at the end, we were still able to be victorious. Hope you guys enjoyed it. I will say I think I like the game slightly better as a competitive game. I have played it competitively and solo. Definitely think the solo is great for you to understand the mechanics. And Jeroboam can give you a challenge. It just depends on how you're playing. And if I'm playing anything wrong, which is a potential, I'll make sure to make notes if I am. Maybe there's something I'm doing wrong that would make him more of a challenge. But for sure, competitively, this game is fun. And it can get pretty competitive over here where you're placing your custom houses and everything. So thank you all so much for watching. I will see you at the next stop.